So anyways, we got a blank canvas here. We're gonna start by making the background. So, I'm gonna take this Persuasion Blue and then I'm gonna grab my Cobalt. Open up the lid, squeeze a little out. That's probably good enough. I want too much. Before we do anything, I gotta get white because I can't just throw a whip on there. And you'll see why. You can always go back and put more on. But when it comes to art, white is used a lot. It's always running away from me. It's always going to the lake.
Go ahead and dip your brush into your Persuasion Blue and mix it with white. Then, you know, just put it up on the canvas, side to side, till it gets to the color that you want, which you'll see here shortly. And then if it's not quite what you like as a color, you can always go back and darken it, lighten it, until it gets to the color that you are wanting or desiring. And in this case, you'll see that I go over it several times, and that's okay because you're trying to get the right sky color.
It's really cool. Once you add the darker blue, it just brings everything together.
Okay, dip your brush into Cobalt and a little bit of white, acrylic white, and put that up on the canvas there. And it's gonna be really cool to fit the background later. And you'll also see why when the darker color for the canyon comes in to play. Yep, feel free to dip back into the acrylic white like I just did and just go side to side. No need to rush it.
I might have said, "Whoa, you made a mistake." No, I didn't make a mistake. It was a happy success story. Once I get this other color on, you'll be like, "Whoa, baby Roo."
So go ahead and dip your brush into acrylic white and cerulean blue and put it back on the canvas, go side to side like I just did. Isn't this so much fun? It's relaxing, isn't it? I just dipped back into Persuasion Blue. I just dipped back into acrylic white, leaving some Persuasion Blue on there. And now I'm grabbing some more white and putting it on the canvas with my brush. And finally, grabbing some more Persuasion Blue and putting that on the canvas. And we're gonna ghost in the canyon of Shoshone Falls.
I woke up one morning and my wife said, "You look a little ghostly today." It always works. Making those little awesome noises. Just like so. Actually, actually helps.
I'm going to grab some more acrylic white and put it up on the canvas and continue to ghost in. The more white you put on your in ghosting in, the better off the effect will be in the end of the step. Continuing to blend the white on the canyon there, and we're creating a friend for the sky. And not just a friend, not any ordinary friend. This is a happy friend for the happy sky. Instead of making friends, we're creating with art friends for the sky to not feel like he's alone. Different times of day require more happier moments. Let's grab some more white and lighten up the sky to make it more happier with its happy friend. Good job, everybody! You're actually painting a happy sky with a happy little canyon. Okay, let's grab the bigger brush again. And we're gonna paint the sky and fill it in a lot more easier. Okay, have fun! You're doing such a good job. Doesn't the sky look happy? That's the ticket. You're doing such a great job. Keep going. Keep painting. Have fun.
And that darker coat is going to bring all this together.
Okay, now grab some more white and blend it in.
It adds texture.
Blend the white acrylic to the sky, going side to side, blend, blend, blend. Okay, we're almost ready now to make a whole lot more happier friends for the sky and the canyon.
Pretend you're making a world. How would you want it to look? Do it. You look at the trees and how happy they are. Look at the leaves in the summertime right before summer ends, and how the shimmering of the light bouncing off of them, how happy they are reaching towards heaven. They praise God all the time.
Let's grab some more cerulean blue and let's blend that into the happy sky. In a couple more minutes, you'll see why. You're doing such a good job. Dip back into the acrylic white and continue painting the happy sky. Okay, we're going back to the persuasion blue and just blend it in. And you'll see the different colors from what we had before to what we have right now. Now, let's put some more white, acrylic white, onto our brush and blend it in. Blend it into the happy sky. Step two, we are going to dip our brush into ultramarine blue, and we're going to paint the canyon. You can pretty much use persuasion blue if you'd like, but ultramarine blue is a little more of that deep blue. I like painting with ultramarine blue because it makes the shadows easier when we're going into more detail later, to not have to run back into doing those shadows. Maybe touch them up a little bit, but that it's already set in the foreground, and this is sets the mood for the your happy success story. And don't worry, there are no mistakes. You're doing good. Keep going. One step at a time, like little bit by little bit, we're getting there. And have fun. Okay, that's what we're looking for. We're starting to get the look of the canyon. God was having a great day when he created this planet with all of its happy little canyons.
Kind of see what's going on there.